Hello and welcome, dear students of class 11th. Today we are going to take up the question and answer section of the chapter titled The Many and the None. So the first question we have is, biodiversity refers to A. varieties of plant life on earth, B. variety and variability of animal life on earth, C. variety and variability of plant, animal and human life on earth. So the correct option is the third one, that is variety and variability of plant, animal and human life on earth. So the second question is, do you think it is good to have a variety of species? Give reasons. Answer to the second question is, yes, I think it is good to have a variety of species. First and foremost, it adds spice to life and make it interesting and enjoyable. Secondly, variety also gives us many choice from which we can select one and reject others. Thirdly, different varieties of organisms help them survive by helping one another in the food chain. Fourthly, different varieties of species exhibit different traits and genetic makeup. Thus, having different species adds up to the gene pool, that is collection of genes of the earth ecosystem. Third question is, biological diversity can be seen in the following areas. Take the correct option. First, in the genes of the various living creatures, yes, it is correct. In the different types of wood and mangoes, it is also correct. In the variety of colors made from vegetable dyes, it is also correct. In the uniforms we wear to school, that is wrong. In the animals found around us, correct. In the ecosystem that exists in the different parts of the world, correct. In the cars we drive, wrong. In the gadgets we use at home, wrong. The fourth question is, certain animals have been described as being charismatic. What does this mean? The word charismatic means attractive and appealing. By describing certain animals as charismatic, the writer means that these animals are very attractive for the person looking at them. Though all creatures on the earth are charismatic in themselves, but certain animals like lion, tiger, leopard, hangul, dolphin, sharks, etc. are more charismatic than others. Question number fifth is, there is a quote from the text. They are used as flagship species for conservation programs. Who does they refer to? What is meant by flagship? What does this statement mean? Answer. They refer to the charismatic animals that evoke awe and excitement in us. The word flagship means main or important. So if a species is used as a flagship animal or flagship species, that means that it is the main animal of that program. For an instance, tigers are the flagship species for the Project Tiger initiative launched by Government of India in 1973. Thus, the statement they are used as flagship species for conservation programs means that certain animals are used as the main animals for conservation projects. Question number six, what do the writers mean when they say that vegetables are being doctored? Is it good to do so? Give reasons for your answer. By the statement that vegetables are being doctored, the writers mean that greedy farmers are playing with the vegetables by injecting growth hormones in them. The reason for doing so is to prepare the vegetables for market and also to give them some decent look. It is completely wrong and dangerous for the innocent consumers who, unaware of this foul play, buys vegetables and consume them. So, the chemicals which are present in the hormones endanger the lives of the people and could cause many diseases. Also, doctoring and growing selective types of vegetables cause the decline in the biodiversity of vegetables and fruits. Question number 7 is, do you think the writer's comparison of the ship losing nuts to the loss of biodiversity is apt? Why do they make this comparison? Answer: The writer's comparison of the sheep losing nuts to the loss of biodiversity is very appropriate. I think the reason behind using such a simile by the writers is that it will make the readers understand the problem easily and devise methods to prevent it. Question number 8. The reason for the loss of biodiversity is, take the right option. First, the arrogance of humans who believe that all the resources of the world are only meant for their sole use and consumption. Second, the global changes taking place during the natural causes. Third, the lack of balance between progress and conservation. So the correct option is the third one, the lack of balance between progress and conservation. Question number 9. Does the future of India's agriculture lie in high-tech biotechnology being promoted by agricultural scientists? Why or why not? The future of India's agriculture does not lie in high-tech biotechnology being promoted by agricultural scientists, because such programs are far removed from the very characteristic of nature and natural phenomena. Nature favors diversity, and in case of agriculture, biological diverse farming is the future for Indian agriculture. Question number 10. How is the loss of biodiversity linked to the survival of the common people of that area? Biodiversity is directly linked to the survival of the common people of that area, as their existence and survival depend on the different types of plants growing in that area. For instance, hundreds of millions of small farmers, fisher folks, herders, and hunter-gatherers depend on the diversity of species, genetic varieties, and ecosystem services for their livelihoods and cultural lives. Question number 11. What is biopiracy? How does it affect a country? Answer: Biopiracy is the theft of plant variety, genetic codes, or age-old knowledge regarding important plants and animals by big companies or corporates. It affects a country by robbing it of its precious plants and animal varieties, and also making them dependent on others, especially corporates, for rights and permissions regarding experiments or research with those plants or animals. The last question is, what is the message in the statement made by the American chief Settle? Answer: The message in the statement made by the American chief Settle is very clear and universally applicable. It presents humans the simple fact that our existence is completely dependent on biodiversity of plants and animals. We, when hungry, need biodiversity to present us with different types of dishes and cuisines, as money cannot be eaten and cannot quench our hunger and thirst. So that was all for the question and answer section of the chapter titled The Many and the None. Thank you so much for watching.